For our rules of the game today, I just want to touch back on what we talked about, the free kicks and the different types. So there's direct free kicks and indirect free kicks, and of course, penalty kicks. So a penalty kick is of course, when a foul is committed inside the box, and the penalty kick is performed from a 12-yard distance or 11 meters, and it's a direct shot, as you know, right in front of the goalie, no defenders. The interesting rule about that one is it doesn't have to be a direct kick on goal. You can actually pass it to a teammate. It's rarely done, but it is done. There are also indirect kicks from inside the box. Now, indirect in general means that you cannot go directly on goal. I mean, you can go directly on goal, but if nobody touches the ball other than the shooter, then it won't count. So you actually have to either pass the ball or have an opponent deflect it in. Now, an indirect kick in front of the box, it happens especially on a back pass. So if you pass back on the goalie and they pick it up with their hands, that's an indirect kick. Now, for an indirect kick, you are allowed to put a wall inside the box, right? So indirect kicks allow for a wall, and they need to be touched twice before they go in the goal. Now, as we said before, the direct kicks are direct shots outside the box. If they're in the box, they're penalty kicks. All right, this is just to add to the rule of free kicks in general. All right, let's go on with our drills.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another warm-up. And today, I'm going to lead your warm-up. So let's get started. do some arm circles, some backward circles. Just whatever else you need to stretch, warm up, make sure you do that, and yeah.
All right, soccer players, for today's trapping drill, we're going to work again on our thigh traps, but as you saw in previous videos, I was working with a partner, and I was trapping a ball that was coming to me mid-height. Today, I'm going to work on balls that I produce myself, on high balls that I produce myself. So I'm going to pick up the ball, kick it up in the air, and then I'm going to show you how to trap, so I'm going to force myself to trap one time with the left, one time with the right, and then alternate. First, let's just do it where we pick up the ball, toss it up in the air, and trap it with the thigh. So like this, trap with the right. Now we toss, trap with the left. Again, this, see how it just falls with it? This, I'm coming down for a more advanced way to do it. We're going to pick up the ball with our feet, kick it up, and toss it down. Okay. And down, again. That's it. All right, as you get better, we're going to have to send the ball a lot higher and make it challenging for us. As you see, it goes pretty high, but the important thing is soft part of the muscle and coming down with the foot a little bit. Left foot. Matter of trying it a lot of times, making sure again you get on the soft part of the thigh and lowering the leg. This dribbling drill now that I prepared right here is an evolution of that stop and a dime. Okay, so we're gonna do it twice, basically starting at the white cone back there, going to the orange cone, coming back to the white, and then the blue cone to do it at a higher speed. So each time we're going to try something different. The first time we're going to do it with the inside of the foot, the second time with the outside of the foot, then we're going to do it with a fullback, and the fourth time with a croix. Again, you'll get to see an example of each. try what is called the through pass today. All right, the through pass, as the word says, is a pass that goes through people. Now, in this case, we set it up so that our orange cones is where I'm going to move horizontally. I'm the passer, all right? And our opponents are the sets of blue cones. So 2 feet and 2 feet, all right? We don't want them to intercept the ball. So I'm going to go across this thing and then send the ball to my red target right here, okay? So hopefully I hit that without sending the ball in the cones. And we're going to do it with the left foot, with the right foot, and both inside and outside of the foot for those of you that want to try that level of difficulty, okay? In any case, just try to send the ball through the blue cones and right into the red target on the bottom. All right, let's start with the right foot pass, for example, okay? So I'm going to go from cone to cone, and as I come back, I send the pass. Right here, right inside, I use my right foot, turn around, come here, I see the opening, and boom, I send it. So that was good. Now let's try with the left foot. So I'm going to start on this side, inside of the left. I'm going to drive the ball, okay, to this cone, and then I'm going to come back, see the opening, and then boom, right through. That was good. If you want to try something a little more difficult, we can also try with the outside of the foot. So with the outside of the foot, it would look like this. You start on this cone, I use the outside, all right, this, I go to the cone, come back, now I eye the opening, and then with the outside of the foot, I just flick it. So I missed my target in the first attempt, it's totally okay. It's important to try and try and try until we get it right. So let's go again with the outside of the foot, of the right foot. I go here, turn around, see the opening, and hit it. Now it's better, I just make some adjustments. Finally, let's try with the outside of the left. I'm gonna start here, outside of the left foot, hit it a couple of times, turn around, see the opening, and flick it. Alright, you try it. For our shooting drill today, we have something exciting. We're gonna get to try the fakes. Alright, so the fakes, you can do a lot of different types of fakes. So one fake is simply stopping the foot in front of the ball. So you stop the foot in front of the ball and then you move it away, okay? Another type of fake is you put your foot on top of the ball and then you move it, okay? You can roll it. Another one is you stop the foot and then you move it with the other foot, okay? And then one is like faking to go this way, so missing the ball, but then coming this way, all right? So let's see how they work here. What I want to do is do the fake with the left foot so that I set up my right foot. So let's see the first one. I go through the cone, right? I fake and move this way and take my shot. All right? For our second one, I'm going to go and then fake by putting the foot on top of the ball. So I go like this, fake, roll it. For the third fake, I'm going to stop the foot, but then I'm going to move it with the right foot, okay? So maybe they're expecting me to do something with the left foot. I get there, I do this, but then I move it with the right, and then I take it down, okay? For the final fake, I'm going to go to the side of the ball, and then move it in, okay? So to the side of the ball, and flick it in, alright? So this, see? Alright, have some fun with these fakes. Alright kids, for this one, we are going to ask you to design your own offensive play. This is our strategy session, and so we want to see what you can come up with. And you know, it could be something like, go down the wing and cross it in. Or I give and go through the middle, or dribble, turn, pass the ball back, and go for a long pass. Anything you can think of. You can use cones, put them down on the ground. You can use a piece of paper and make a drawing, or you can enact it. Alright, use your creativity, use the knowledge that you gained in these 10, 12 sessions, and create your own strategic offensive plays. Alright, I'm curious to see see what you come up with. Okay, for today's goalie skills, I want to challenge you to a situation, a particular situation. There is a breakaway, so your opponent is coming in and maybe a little bit to an angle. Now, the goalie, what you don't want to do is to tie the goal, because from this distance, you would allow your opponent to come in way too close, and then there's too much to cover in too little of space and too little of time. So what you have to do when there's a breakaway, and it's a one-on-one situation, you gotta come out, right? You gotta come out of the goal, but if you come out standing up like this, you're very weak down here. It's difficult to react and actually catch the ball. So you have to lower your hand, right? Now, this is the first you're gonna do, is you're gonna lower your hand so that if there's a shot, you actually have four limbs protecting the ball. So you can just simply do this. Now, it is faster to do this and come up with your hands than to lower them, okay? So, and it's more likely, I mean, it's obviously quicker for somebody to shoot the ball on the ground than to lift it. So that's why you gotta start with your hands low. So now, the other thing is you don't wanna expose too much one or the other thing. So usually what goalies do, they come out like this, all right? And then as they get close to the opponent, they basically save this side, okay, by opening up, and then they stretch out the hand. So this is a position, you can see maybe if I back it up a little bit. So when you're low on the ground to this, you don't have to necessarily be down. Eventually you'll do this and then stick out the foot. So basically you're forcing your opponent to hit in the upper corner. Because if you go for the lower corner, okay, on that side, you can reach with the foot, okay? If you go through the legs, hopefully you keep your knee close enough, okay, to where there's very little space and maybe your foot is coming behind, so you can save it, all right? Now, this hand is protecting this, and then this hand may be able to hit the ball on the rise. This corner is difficult for the attacker to hit because there's very little space to get the ball high. So again, the correct position when coming out is this. You're coming out, all right? You're leaning towards the close to the first post, all right, this way, and then you stretch the leg out for the second. All right, kids, the challenge of today is gonna be a breakaway. So we set up a situation where I have to go through the orange cones, which wouldn't exist in the real game. Now, that chair is our goal, and I have to figure out a way to score just right after I pass the orange cone. So, nice and slow, I'm gonna come here, right? Then either go for the outside, see the goalie back, I'm gonna have to try to score by doing maybe the outside. Or maybe I'm gonna try with the other foot. Maybe I can go through the legs of the goalie. Or maybe I can even try to go above. Okay, your turn to try. You have to do it 10 times and see how many times you score. All right, everyone, excellent workout today. We really put some effort in this, and I definitely feel my calves and my quads, so let's make sure we get a good stretch on that. So for the calves, you can do them on the ground. You can start with something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Maybe go to 10 or 15. Other leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then let's go and actually grab the tip of the foot so we actually stretch our shin a little bit more. So for now, just, again, push some pressure, put some pressure on the tip of the foot so that it's straightens out our shin muscle. That's about 10 seconds, maybe 15 or so per leg. Again, tip of the foot, and make sure that your foot is facing upward. You're working on that shin muscle. Okay, very good. All right, let's do a little bit of hamstring. Be a little bit light when you're running a lot or kicking the ball, you know, for soccer or so. And other sports that stretch the hamstring too much, don't exaggerate. It's a pretty delicate one. not, just want to put my hand facing on the ground. I'm not exaggerating. To do the upper part, so the glutes, you want to bend your legs and just hang. Okay. Now we're going to our quads. Okay. So in this case, I'm going to grab more of the ankle. Okay. We are not interested anymore in stretching the shin. Now we're focusing on the quad. Okay. Make sure that the ankle pulls in. And you should feel it right in the front of the thigh. Good. Same thing here. For the other side. We're grabbing on the ankle. Pulling in. Very good. Keep it for about 10 seconds. For values of the day, I want to make sure that you set a good example for your teammates, especially your younger teammates. Meanwhile, we're going to do some pressing poses. So straight leg and throw your chest back. You should feel it in your hip flexors and abs. All right, so throw it back. Again, be an example to your teammates. Be a role model. In today's world, it's more and more difficult to find good role models, but it's something that is really important. Because we want to pass on our positive experience to others. And of course, if you're supportive, others will gain confidence, will have a lot of respect for you. Very good. Put your chest back. All right. One drill that you can do for your abs, stretch your abs, is get on the ground with your hips down and push it up. It's called a cobra in yoga. It's very good. Back, it finally shortens the muscles that have been working pretty hard during the workout. Good. This is also the time where you can do the tilts and actually hold the position for 10-15 seconds. You obviously should do the stretches a little longer, so for the video, I'm doing them a little shorter than I should. Anyway, great workout. Be supportive with your teammates, of course, with your opponents too. Set the example. See you next time.